based on?
This is 3D information, digital maps extracted from the Statue of Liberty.
The Statue of Liberty?
Yeah, and then turned what I call convolved or synthesized. Convolved and synthesized into a three-dimensional form. The machine will cut.
Stuff. Half metal, half coke, so it's pretty nasty. But
you do what you gotta do.
Thank you. scaled down version of an industrial iron melting furnace. And as you see the process later, it's a batch melter. It melts a certain amount of iron at a time, and then that gets tapped out of that hole at the bottom, the funnel. The iron melts at 2,350 degrees Fahrenheit, and I want to try and get the furnace up to at least 2,500 or 2,600 degrees, so we get nice hot metal. These are the molds that the metal will be poured into. We carry the molten metal over to here and pour down into these funnels. Inside here is a negative space of the sculpture. For example, in this one here, it's one of these pieces. This was cast earlier, and I did a bit of an experiment with this one. I put iron in the furnace and then a bit of copper in there, so the two metals melt together and you get this beautiful sort of blushing iron. This is a mold that I'm preparing. This is a resin bonded sand, a sodium silicate sand. It's a two-part resin that you mix into dry sand in a cement mixer, a bit like a two-part glue, and then after about 5 hours it hardens up. You can carve this sand, you can do any number of things to it to get your sculpture. This is actually the inside of a sculpture, and then the iron is going to come on the top of it. Before you put your mold together, you put what's called a mold wash on, which is a graphite, an alcohol base, and that helps the mold release from the metal and also fills in any gaps between the grains of sand, so you get a really nice fine detail. Once you've covered the painted this mixture on, you then light it so that it cures and bakes onto the mold. Once you've done that, you can then assemble your molds together as we saw previously. Big ones. To make a crackle effect when I put the copper on. This is real copper here. This is cast copper and iron. When I cast this piece, I put a mixture of copper cable and cast iron radiators into the furnace, melted them together, and you get this mixture. Stripes.
was that?
The Great Gate of Kiev is sketched for a proposed gate of that great city in Russia.
Given this way, because the government wouldn't provide direct testimony from these people, and that this is the best.
Industrial city of Birmingham, which I believe is named after Birmingham in England, which is the industrial centre of England, it's the heart of England.
What's this thing do?
This is the furnace.
Really?
You know my little cupola? It's a big version.
Right.
This is the real thing. But this makes iron from iron ore. Whereas you couldn't melt iron ore in mine. Right. So this does. This takes the actual raw material, melts it down, and they used to pour tap out here, and then this whole area was a sand pit where they would have make all the pigs
right.
in this sand. And then pig iron could be melted down or forged or taken through different processes.
And how hot did it get?
Oh,
how much can it hold?
I don't know.
Doesn't say.
It would be continual.
Right.
So it would be running continual.
Crazy.
They would tap it out every 4 hours, so they'd let all the iron accumulate in the bottom and then tap it out. This is the slag hole. During the process, slag is produced and comes out of here, and that was a continual flow of slag. People had to get out of the way. I don't know where they put it. Down there. Water cooling the furnace, cooling the wind box.
fucking race car for that.
How do you like them?
I'm fairly pleased with it, yeah. I think the colour works. And I'm glad we got them out here.